For something different, I'm going to open up Composition 1.3 Paint Starter. Again, I have a figure standing off to one side that I want to focus on, but there's additional details in this scene that I might want to focus on as well. I can create multiple mask shapes, or I can use a different tool. I can use the Paint tool for this. When you use the Paint tool, you want to be in the layer panel, so I'm going to double-click my footage to open it in its special layer panel, and I'm actually going to select the Eraser tool rather than the Paint tool. My Paint and Brushes panels have opened. I'm going to move them somewhere where it's a little easier to see what's going on. There's Paint, and there's Brushes. I'm not cloning, so I'll close this up and create some more space. There's a few parameters you need to carefully set up. In the Paint panel, make sure Channels is set to RGBA. The A stands for alpha, and we do need to create some transparency in this. Set Duration to Constant, because we want our strokes to last the entire length of this composition. And set Erase to Layer Source and Paint. Once you have those set up, we can turn to Brushes and decide what size brush we want. As I drag my cursor over this image, you can see my brush right now is very tiny. It's that little circle, and that's hardly big enough. I can go pick a preset brush that's pretty big and soft, like around 200 looks like a good size. I can manually edit it down here in diameter and hardness, which is the amount of feathering. Or I can edit the brush size interactively over here in the layer panel. If I hold Command on Mac or Control on Windows and drag, I can adjust how big my brush is. If I keep my finger on the mouse button, then release Command or Control, now I can set how big the feather is inside. So I can see what's going to be my opaque part of the brush, and the distance between those circles is my fall off. That's a bit big, so I'm going to go ahead and make actually a smaller brush. I'm going to go down to smaller in size, release, move in, somewhere around there. Good. Now I'm ready to start painting. I just click and paint over this guy who I intend to keep later on. Make a second stroke over here, include some of those flowers, fill in down here. And I can edit these later, by the way. I'm going to go over to these gravestones, and I'm actually going to make a smaller brush. So I'm going to hold down Command or Control, reduce the size of my brush, release Control, and go smaller from feather. Now that I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and drag this down this row of gravestones. Now that I've blotted out the sections that I wish to keep, I'm going to return to my composition panel and type E. Paint is actually an effect that is applied to a layer. And just like we earlier cut and paste the mask shape to another solid, we're going to do the same thing here. I'm going to select Paint, do Command X on Mac, Control X on Windows to cut it, go to Layer, New Solid, make a black solid that's a whole comp size, okay, and paste onto it. And now you see what we were doing. We were basically creating transparency wherever we wanted to show the underlying layer. And again, to adjust the strength of this, we type T for opacity and fade it down or fade it up to get the amount of effect that we want. Now that I've done this and I'm seeing it in context, I'm realizing that I'm not entirely happy with my brush size or feather. But the really cool thing about Paint is that it's very easy to adjust these after the fact. So I'm going to type E to reveal Paint. I'm going to twirl open and see my three eraser strokes. There was my first stroke on the guy, the second, and the third for the gravestones. I'm going to start by twirling down the gravestones and editing their stroke options. This could be a lot softer, so I'm going to take the hardness brush parameter and reduce it all the way to get something nice and soft around those gravestones. I can also reduce the diameter to make it a little bit tighter on those, maybe somewhere around there. And I can even make it a separate opacity. I can make them a little less vignetted, maybe tone down their individual opacity around there. So that's nice. I'm going to go back to this guy's main stroke. I'm also going to soften up his feather on his brush so I get a little tighter on him. I like that a bit better. Since I like that setting, I'm just going to select it. Do Command C on Mac, Control C on Windows to copy it. Select Eraser Stroke 2, and then paste it to soften up that as well. If I feel the vignette is still too loose around his body, I'll just change the diameter of the brush and pull that in a little bit like that. There we go. Before and after. Again, I'll press T for opacity and back off the effect a little bit. So it's just a subtle darkening like that, rather than anything too harsh. There, there. Now, the advantages of using the Paint tool is that it's very flexible. You can really draw these different shapes, have individual feathering amounts on your different strokes, and really control how your vignette looks after the fact. The disadvantage of using paints is, well, frankly, it is a lot of work to set up. And it is also an effect. There are some cases where we cannot use paint, and I'll show those later.